So what I'm going to talk about is a little bit different. I'm going to talk about chess. Why chess is very easy because this was my first job. I was a professional chess player a long, long time ago. And then I did a little bit of theoretical physics, and now I'm working in this industry for more than 20 years, mainly in video before. That's why I have only few friends here and not as many as in IBC, for instance, but I'm in the broadband world since 1 year, more or less now, really still enjoying and learning a lot. Okay. So if you want to learn chess on what I'm going to talk about, I will talk about purple as well, don't worry. if you want to learn how to play chess, there are two different things you have to do. The first one is to learn the rule, and this is very easy. It takes 2 hours to anyone. Just basically the material, the movement, and what we have to do. Second, because here then you know how to play chess, but you don't know how to play chess well. This is a very big difference. And then you need to understand how these pieces are going to collaborate together in order to reach this final goal. So the first one is what we have been calling here the ecosystem, and the second one is doing a smart play with this ecosystem, and this is where we are going to. Okay, so not complex box, if you compare with all the boxes that I saw before, which are great, by the way, I took a lot of pictures, thank you guys. This one is pretty simple, but basically it takes just to understand where the ecosystem is coming from, it's very easy, and we know a lot about it. There is first the hardware layer, and what are the hardware guys? Basically, it's chipset makers and CPU manufacturers, mainly what Vantiva does. And this guy, let's say that these are the Bishop and the Knight. These two guys work very well together, so it makes sense. So that's why, and they are kind of in the middle. Then we have the framework, purple itself. This is the tower, and the tower plays very well with the pawn. If someone is interested why, I can explain one, but I have only 15 minutes for that. And the applications. We have a lot of applications, a lot of pawns, and pawns are extremely important, and we spoke about it a lot during all this presentation. I see a funny face. What is going to say about this chess stuff? But okay, we are going there. Pawns are very important. We'll come back to the point part. And we have the operator. Of course, the operator is the queen. Everyone is working for the queen. He's basically he's here about us. And one piece is missing. Which one? Of course, the king. And what is the king? You are two good guys. Everyone was listening to all those. Yeah, we have to remember all the time that we are not playing only for the queen. Sorry for... I've been working for Orange for 18 years before being Inventiva, so I consider you my friends, guys. So we are not only playing for the queen, we are playing for the king. And what is very funny is if you listen to the operators, Orange and AT&T, Verizon, all the guests that we have been listening during the day, everyone is talking about the king. Everyone is talking about the end user. And so we need to keep this focus and then start to move on. So this is the ecosystem. Okay, then let's see what we do with these pieces. All what I wrote here, it's very easy to be the last one because everything was said. More or less, it's basically the goals on each and every one. And we see that sometimes these goals are complementary, sometimes they are not completely aligned. And sometimes we can even push and they can be contradictory way of seeing things. Okay, just to give an example, we want to sell hardware. We want to renew the hardware. We want to have a new hardware with a lot of new features all the time. We want to be like telephones. But on the other side, operators would like to have refurbish and want to have gateways that last for, I don't know, 10 years. On the same for set-top box, by the way. and then we can reach different things. So the first lesson that you learn from chess is that all these pieces must work in a perfect harmony, in a kind of orchestra, in order to win the game. If you forget one of them, it's not going to work. And one of the best one who understood and knows how to do this was Karpov. Karpov was very, very strong. He was not a big tactician like Kasparov or Fischer, but he really understood how to maximize the power of all the pieces. And this is what we need to do if we want to win this game. What I wanted, you will learn something, I think, today, is this guy. This guy is called Philidor. He was a musician. He was doing composing operas, and during his spare time, he was playing chess, and he was by far the best of the world in his time, but by far. Why? Because he was the first one who really tried to understand the chess game, and he wrote a very nice book, L'analyse du jeu d'échecs, in French, you can guess what it means. and he said something extremely important for this meeting here. He said, les pions sont l'âme des échecs, which means pawns are the soul of chess. And you remember what soul are? Applications. They are extremely important, and they are the soul of the game that we are playing. And everyone said already, if we do a platform that doesn't take into account the application and the way the application needs to work, we are missing the soul of the game we are playing, and we are not going to win, guys. Okay? So at least you know Philidor. No one really knows this guy, but he was really a great champion, the best French chess player ever. Okay, let's talk about money and love now a little bit, because here I took the point of view of the king. You remember the king, the end user. So here the value on the love. The love is how much he loves his devices. Okay, instead of level of love, I could have put, to be honest, I could have put a number of applications or is really using. And this is. Yes, sorry, there is no reference on this graph because it's just based on my feeling. There is no statistic on this. But it's very interesting. Everyone loves his smartphone, and we have, I don't know, 10, 12, 20 applications we are using. On the great gateway, I put it there. Sorry, guys. Setup box, I'm coming from there, is not that better. On there, I put some of the other things. When you want to learn about how to play smart chess, what you start doing is studying the games of the champions. So let's go to the smartphone game. This is really interesting because we have all the pieces that we have here, exactly the same. We have a great platform that we are building together with Purple that is already there, either done by Steve or done by Google with the Android framework, which is an amazing framework to develop applications. And there is other things that are a little bit interesting is that the hardware, and I like this curve, is basically the blue one is the price of the average price of the smartphone over years. So it goes up. It goes up, why? Because it's not only about having a great platform, it's also about having a great hardware that gives you capabilities to create new applications that are going to make this device more and more attractive and increase the level of love of the king. It's really the way it goes. And in red, just for you to know, for all our friends that were there building apps, it's the app revenue worldwide. We are talking about 130 billion of dollars. So you are in the right place if we manage to reach this. Another example that I love is the set-top box, because I'm coming from there. Well, I'm still there. I didn't. And what's the difference? It's really interesting because basically, if you think about the set-top box, you have already a platform that is fantastic in order to build applications. You have a great network. You have almost everything. What you don't have today is the hardware dynamic that makes things moving up and moving up. And you can see the price of the set-top box average, they are going down. It's not like the smartphone that was going up. Here, it's going down. And this is a game that we are all playing, guys. It includes the operators, of course. And everyone has his point of view. But if we keep that trend, we may end up with only 10K application, only, okay, it's a lot, but it has nothing to do with the almost 5 million that we find in the mobile world. Nothing to do. I don't know if even someone here has installed an Android TV application last year, but on your mobile phone for sure. So something has to do here, and this is my main message here, is that we need to play in with all the pieces. Otherwise, if we miss something, we could have the better purple platform of the world. It's not going to help to make the ramp up that we see in the other things. There is an interesting last point, the soundbar, which we are not the only one doing the soundbar. Here it's our soundbar, of course, but you can find others. Where basically we are adding value. It costs more. But what people use, just one application more that we install is Spotify. That they are basically the only one installing Spotify in the soundbar. Why? Because you don't need to turn on your TV, you just use it, and then you start increasing. So it's again a view, a global view of the market. So if we want to go on, this was said 20 times today. Sorry for repeating. And these are just use cases that we imagined, but there are probably more. The more hardware, the more capabilities we will be adding to this gateway, the more use cases and the more creativity in the app, which are the soul of the game that we are playing, we will be developing. And this is extremely important, because all of these businesses are driven by the premium segment. This is what brought the telephone to the place that it's today, when they start adding a lot of capabilities, cameras, sensors, and blah, blah, blah. So we can imagine start adding things to the gateways today to see. And I think this is the ideal place to start doing this experiment, guys. We have everyone here. We don't need anyone else than the people in this room to start building things, to start pushing these kind of things to the market. And this is what is going to create a full application ecosystem that will create the success we are looking for. OK, so it's just an animation. It was nice. So yeah, I love it. So we have the platform incubator, all these pieces. And again, please don't miss anyone there. That makes the application roll, then the king is very happy. And when the king is very happy, start rolling back to the other way around, and all this stuff start growing all together in the right direction we want to go. Sorry for my colleagues, but I need to talk a little bit about Vantiva. then I'm done. Just two seconds. I don't know how. OK. Sorry. Vantiva, okay, we have been playing in the open source game for a very long time, and we will continue. So the good news is that I am in charge of the software of Vantiva. Whatever software you think about, you can come to me. So we are personally also pushing to go into this new open source area, which is purple, which I think is growing if we take the right direction. We want to engage. Vantiva was not there before, you can see it. But we are strongly engaging with software development that we want to contribute to. We want to be very active in proposing prototype of CPEs. So think about new use cases, new sensors, new things that you can imagine, so that we can propose and help with that. And of course, we have all the knowledge of software integration and testing that we can put to support this community. And this is an engagement of Antiva. Thank you.